So today topic is what? Determinant. Are you able to see the board?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
now,
sir.
In yes, that, sir. Any observation is there?
NT is printed in blue.
Okay. So later we'll discuss why. Okay. Now, write the definition. Determinant. Is a function determinant is a function which assign each square matrix to a unique real or complex number. See once again definition. Determinant is a function which assigns each square matrix to a unique real or complex number. That is D real or complex. So determinant is a function from set of square matrices to a set of real numbers or complex numbers. If A is a square matrix, if A is a square matrix of order n, if A is a square matrix of order n, then determinant of the square matrix, if A is a square matrix of order n, then determinant of the square matrix A denoted by DET of A or between two vertical lines, you write the matrix A. You should not get confused the symbol here. This symbol we are using for a what? Modulus also, but you have to read this modulus when inside is a real number. But here inside is not a real number, inside is a matrix. So this you have to read it as determinant of the square matrix A. Let us take an example. A equal to 1, 2, 5, 0, 1, 3. -1, 2, 4. Then we can write as determinant of A or determinant of A equal to, write the elements only between two vertical lines. 1, 2, 5, 0, 1, 3, -1, 2, 4. Here we are discussing just notation only. Next, determinant of a square matrix of order 1. Determinant of a square matrix of order 1. Determinant of a square matrix of order 1. Now, A equal to A 1 1. Now, here the order is what? 1 by 1. So the determinant is defined as determinant of A, that is determinant of A 1 1. Which is equal to the number itself. So determinant of a square matrix of order 1 by 1 is the value itself, that is the element only. Example, determinant of 5 equal to 5 only. Suppose A equal to minus 3, 1 by 1 matrix, then determinant of A equal to determinant of minus 3, which is equal to what? Minus 3 only. Don't write as plus 3. Don't get confused here with the modulus. Next, determinant of a square matrix A of order 2. Determinant of a square matrix A of order 2. Let us take a general form. A equal to A11, A12, A21, A22. Then determinant of A equal to determinant of A11, A12, A21, A22. Now, how it is defined as the cross product? That is A11, A22 minus A21, A12. A11, A22 minus A21, A12. If I take A equal to square matrix A, B, C, D, then determinant of A, tell me what is this equal to?
AD minus BC.
The cross product AD minus BC. Example, A equal to minus 3, 0, 1, 4. Calculate determinant of A. Minus 3 into 4 minus 1 into 0. That is minus 12. A equal to 1, 4, 3 minus 2. Tell me determinant of A.
Minus 14.
Minus 14. Determinant of cos theta minus sin theta. Sin theta cos theta. Tell me what is this equal to? That is cos square theta minus half minus plus sin square theta. That becomes 1. Now, let us discuss the meaning now. In the word determinant, what is the observation here?
It is in view.
It is like determine. Word is there?
Yes.
Right. Determinant. Determinant. Determines. Mute it. Determinant determines something. What is that something? Because in the name itself, we are having determined. That is, determinant determines something. What is that something is? Determinant determines something. So what is that something is? Right. Number one. For a system of linear equations, for a system of linear equations, for a system of linear equations, determinant, for a system of linear equations, determinant determine number of solutions. For a system of linear equations, determinant determine number of solutions. Next, one more. Geometrically, geometrically determinant, geometrically determinant determine, geometrically determinant determine area. Geometrically determinant determine area for a 2x2 square matrix.
Only
for a 3x3 square matrix. For a 3x3 square matrix. For a 3x3 square matrix, it determines the volume. For a 3x3 square matrix, determinant determines the volume. Example, for a 3x3 square matrix, example for a 3x3 square matrix, determinant corresponds to volume of parallelepiped. Volume of parallelepiped. You will come across this in vectors chapter. Maybe in physics you have learned. Anybody knows what is volume of parallelepiped? When A bar, B bar, C bar are the adjacent edges,
No.
A bar, B bar, C bar are the adjacent edges of a parallelepiped. But this volume, if you remember, scalar triple product of A bar, B bar, C bar. Okay, that anyway we are going to discuss in the vector chapter. Okay, right now just you remember. Now, let us discuss the system of equations. How you are relating to the number of solutions, as well as we'll discuss 2x2 square matrix, how it is corresponds to the area, that is area of a parallelogram. Consider the system of equations AX plus BY equal to E, CX plus DY equal to F. Consider the system of equations AX plus BY equal to E, CX plus DY equal to F. All of you solve the system of equations and tell me what is x equal to, what is y equal to, using any of the methods which you know already, either elimination method or substitution method or cross multiplication method. Solve it and tell me what is x and what is y. The method what I am doing is what?
Cross
multiplication method.
X is minus BF plus AD upon AD minus BC.
Wait. Let us do all. Check all of you, x equal to
minus
bf plus ed minus bf upon ed minus bc comma y equal to af minus ce upon ed minus bc. Check, have you got this?
Yes.
Now, in this, please. Now, is there any observation in the solution? Is there any observation in the solution?
They all represent a determinant value.
Observe the coefficients here. What are the coefficients? A, B, C, D. Check all of you. The system of equations I can represent in matrix notation in this form. That is a square matrix A, B, C, D, and this is a variable matrix and this is a constant matrix. This is called matrix equation. Now, from the matrix equation, can you able to get the system of equations? Check properly. So you need to multiply row with column. Now when I multiply first row with the column, I will get as what? AX plus dy equal to e, cx plus dy equal to f. That means I am rewriting the system of equations to another form, which is called matrix equation. In this, the matrix A, B, C, D is called coefficient matrix. Coefficient matrix. Because these are the coefficients of the variables. And the column matrix X, Y is called variable matrix. Because it contains the variables. And the right hand side column matrix is called the constant matrix, because it contains the constants. You should remember how to convert system of equations to the matrix equation, as well as matrix equation to the system of equations. Now here the coefficient matrix is what? A, B, C, D. That is, if I denote the matrix as A, B, C, D. Now, can you tell me what is this determinant of a 2 by 2 square matrix? AD minus BC. Now, is this AD minus BC? Observe with respect to the solution, where it is involved? In the denominator. So based on the value of the denominator, that is AD minus BC, you can able to say the number of solutions of the system of equations. If AD minus BC, that is determinant, is not equal to zero, then what you can say about the system of equations? That is, what you can say about the number of solutions?
Definite.
How many solutions?
One.
Good. Only one solution. That is, unique solution will be there. Whenever AD minus BC is not equal to zero, that solution is itself this, X equal to and Y equal to. Whereas, if the determinant AD minus BC equal to zero, then the system of equations may have infinite solutions or no solution also. Either infinite solution or no solution also. That depends on the constant E and F.
What do you mean by no solution?
Now, geometrically, what is this corresponds to? Straight lines?
Yes.
When you plot the straight lines, if the lines are parallel, then will you have any solution?
No.
No solution. That's the meaning of it. That means there is no value of X and Y satisfying both the equations. Suppose if they are intersecting, then you will have only one solution. That intersecting case is possible only when AD minus BC is not equal to zero. And when you will get the infinite solution is, if the lines are coincident. If the lines are coincident, then you will have infinite solution. That is, if you plot the equation geometrically, then you can able to say directly the number of solutions. And this is a mathematical method. So in this method, it is observation is, it is involving with respect to the determinant of a coefficient matrix.
Sir, so is the value of AD minus BC determining the slope of the lines?
Tell me what the slope, how you are saying?
Sir, you said that there can be two possibilities of infinite solutions
that
and
means
no solutions.
You can convert that by calculating the slopes, and when the lines are parallel, when the lines are not parallel, then you can relate to the slopes also. Because the calculation part, it is involving again with this only. Why? Because when you say parallel, the slopes will be equal.
Yes.
So like that, again it corresponds to AD minus BC only. Now, one more we have discussed. For the another one we have discussed geometrically. 2/2 determinant corresponds to what? Area you have written. Now let us discuss that also. Area of the parallelogram formed with the vertices origin origin, one vertex A, another vertex is B, another vertex is P, I am taking. Now, how we are relating the vertices to the system of equations are a given 2/2 matrix is, let us take the same matrix A, 2/2 A, B, C, D. Now, let us take one row as a vertex. That means, I am taking the coordinates of A as A comma B and the coordinates of B as C comma D. Now, with the origin, is it possible to construct a parallelogram? So, O, A, P, B is a parallelogram. Now, so we need to calculate the area of this parallelogram. Now, when you calculate area of this parallelogram, OAPB, area of parallelogram, OAPB, can you able to guess what should be this answer?
AD minus BC.
That is the determinant itself. That is AD minus BC you will get. That we'll try to prove it. Geometrically as well as mathematically also. Now, can you able to say the coordinates of P?
A plus C.
How to calculate the
B.
coordinates of P? Diagonals bisect each other. When diagonals bisect each other, the midpoint of AB is same as midpoint of OP. So you will get as A plus C comma B plus D. Now, let us try first geometrically. How to calculate the area? If I draw the perpendiculars to the x-axis as well as y-axis, observe the figure, all of you. Now, the coordinates of A is A comma B. So, this length will be small a and this will be small b. And coordinates of P are A plus C and B plus D. So, this entire length will be what? A plus C. So, that means this portion will be C. Next, this entire length will be B plus D and this is B already. So the remaining portion will be D. Next, in the same manner, this side, the coordinates of B are C comma D. So this length will be C and here it is D.
Okay. why are we not using the formula for area of
use that also, but after this, because we are geometrically mentioning that it corresponds to the area. Now, what is this length? Can you tell me? What is this length? This portion length?
B.
Because this is entire is what? B plus D. So up to here D, then remaining is B. Now, if you observe, we are having a triangles and rectangles are there. And this portion corresponds to what? A. Now, tell me this area. Area of this triangle.
Half into
AB. Next. Area of this portion, rectangle.
BC.
BC. Next. Area of the above triangle.
Half CD.
Half CD. Next. Area of this triangle.
Half
CD.
Half CD. Area of this rectangle.
BC.
BC. Area of this triangle.
Half AB.
Half AB. Now, can I write the area of the parallelogram using the entire rectangle and by subtracting the squares, that is rectangles and triangles? Simplify and tell me. So, area of parallelogram O A P B equal to entire rectangle area. For the entire rectangle area.
Plus
C into B plus D. Now in the entire rectangle area, you subtract the area of triangle portions and area of smaller rectangles. That is minus, this is 2 times is there, 2 into 1 by 2 AB, this is over. Next, these are also 2 times is there, minus 2 into half CD, these triangles also over. Next, these are the two triangles, two rectangles you are having. Minus 2 into BC. Now simplify this and tell me what you are going to get.
AD minus BC.
Check, are the terms getting cancelled and tell me the remaining terms.
AD minus BC.
Which is same as what? The determinant of a 2 by 2 matrix ABCD. Now here we have taken a first row as one vertex, second row as another vertex. Not necessary that you will take the first row as a vertex. Even if I take first column as one vertex, second column as another vertex and construct the parallelogram, still you are going to get the same area. Now previously you know how to calculate area of a quadrilateral. Have you remembered?
Yes.
In that method, you calculate. You have written a formula also. That is area of a quadrilateral.
Half x1 minus x3, x2 minus x4.
Good.
y1 minus y3, y2 minus y4.
Good. Calculate now that. Now observe, there also what you have written is a determinant only. There we have written as a directly. Now we'll try to convert how you are getting that also in this determinant chapter. Calculate that and verify. You are going to get again AD minus BC. So 3x3 determinant we'll discuss in the vector chapter, not now. Now, right, few more concepts. Minor and cofactor, minor and cofactor of the elements of a square matrix of order n, minor and cofactor of the elements of a square matrix of order n. Write the definition for first minor. Minor of an element, minor of an element Aij, minor of an element Aij of a square matrix A equal to Aij n by n, minor of an element Aij of a square matrix A equal to Aij n by n is denoted by capital M ij, denoted by capital M ij, which is determinant, which is determinant of order, which is determinant of order n minus 1, which is determinant of order n minus 1 obtained by removing the ith row and jth column, of a given matrix A of order n. See, once again, minor of an element Aij of a square matrix A equal to Aij n by n, denoted by capital Mij, which is determinant of order n minus 1, obtained by removing the ith row and jth column of the matrix A of order n. Now, example. Let us take the 2x2 matrix A equal to A11, A12, A21, A22. Now, let us calculate first M11. for the meaning of M11. M11 means minor of an element A11. Minor of element A11. Now, if you observe the definition, for the definition, which is determinant of order n minus 1. That means M11 is a correspond to what now? Determinant of order 1 obtained by removing the ith row and jth column, means first row and first column. So when I remove the first row and first column, what is left out is A22. Now that means for this 1 by 1 matrix A22, that determinant becomes the M11. That is, you should write as determinant of A22. And what is this value? Determinant of a matrix of order 1 by 1 is what? A22 itself. Have you understood this?
Yes.
Now, in the same manner, can you tell me M21? How to read this as? Minor of an element A21.
A12.
Now, which is obtained by removing what?
First row and second column.
Removing second row, first column. Now, what is left out now? A11. See the board and write.
A12.
Second row. Okay, sorry. Second row, first column we are removing. So that means it will be what? A12. Correct. Now let us take a numerical example. A equal to 5 minus 3, 2, 1. Now tell me what is M11. What is M11?
1.
M12. Remove the first row and second column. Two. What is the value?
2.
M22.
5.
Now, let us extend to 3 by 3. 1, 3, minus 1, 2, 1, 0, 4, minus 2, 3. Now, let us calculate first M11.
3.
The definition is same only.
3.
So, what is the definition? Minor of an element A11.
1.
Minor of an element. Write all of in the same manner. 5. Minor of an element A11. What is the definition? It is obtained. And what is the order also? What is the order of the given matrix? 3. Now, as per the definition, minor is a determinant of order how much?
2.
And, which is obtained by eliminating what? First row and first column. So, when I eliminate the first row and first column, whatever the remaining portion is there, that observe, it is a 2 by 2 determinant. 1, 0, minus 2, 3.
3.
Now calculate this determinant. For the determinant,
five.
Determinant.
Five.
How much?
Three.
Five.
Now, go through once again. You are removing first row and first column. The remaining portion of the element will become a 2 by 2 determinant. For the 2 by 2 determinant, you have to calculate the value. Now, in the same manner, let us calculate M21. Don't write the answer directly. First, you write the determinant and then calculate the value. M21. So you have to remove what? Second row and first column. When I remove the second row, first column, tell me the elements row wise.
3 minus 1 minus 2 3.
Okay, now tell me the value.
7.
How much?
7.
9 minus 2, that is 7. Now let us calculate M 2 3. M 2 3
minus 14. Now,
here, what you have to remove? Second row, third column. Now, when I remove the second row, third column, tell me the elements of the determinant now.
1, 3, 4, minus 2.
Now, what this value?
Minus 14.
Minus 2, minus 12. That is minus 14. We have discussed one more name also, along with minor. What is another name we have mentioned?
Cofactor.
Right. Cofactor. 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 Of an element Aij, cofactor of an element Aij denoted by capital Aij, cofactor of an element Aij denoted by capital Aij and defined as capital Aij equal to minus 1 to the power of I plus J into Mij. Minus 1 to the power of I plus J into Mij, where Mij is the minor of an element Aij. Check once again. The cofactor of an element Aij is denoted by capital Aij and defined as minus 1 to the power of I plus J into Mij. That is basically you need to multiply the minor with minus 1 to the power of I plus J. That means it gives you always either plus 1 or minus 1 only based on the exponent. Now, take the same matrix 2 by 2 again. A equal to 5 minus 3, 2, 1. Now, for this, calculate cofactor A, 2, 1. Calculate cofactor A, 2, 1. Now, first write as per the definition. Minus 1 to the power of 2 plus 1 M 2, 1, I should write. Minus 1 to the power of 2 plus 1, M, 2, 1. Now, again, minus 1 to the power of 3, which is minus 1 into M, 2, 1. Then we have to remove the second row, first column. Remove the second row and first column. What is the determinant you are getting? Determinant of what? Minus 3. What is determinant of minus 3? minus 3. That means this becomes what now? Plus 3. Now tell me another example for the same matrix. A 2, 2. So minus 1 to the power of 2 plus 2. M 2, 2. Now tell me what is this equal to?
5.
Minus 1 to the power of 2 plus 5. 2 is what? Positive. So the value will be 5. Now let us consider the 3 by 3 matrix. You write again the same matrix. 3 by 3. 1, 3, minus 1, 2, 1, 0. Four minus two, three. Now, A 1, 3. So A 1, 3 corresponds to what? Cofactor of an element A 1, 3. As per the definition, minus 1 to the power of 1 plus 3, M 1, 3. Now, minus 1 to the power of 1 plus 3. Exponent is even, so it is positive. Now, remove the first row and third column. Mute it. Remove the first row and third column. Tell me the elements of the 2 by 2 determinant now.
2, 1. 4 minus 2.
2, 1, 4, minus 2. Tell me the value.
Minus 8.
Okay. Now let us calculate another. A 2, 3. That is cofactor of an element A 2, 3. As per the definition, minus 1 to the power of 2 plus 3, M 2, 3. Now, again, minus 1 to the power of 2 plus 3 is minus 1. So, minus M 2, 3. That is minor of an element A 2, 3. So, remove the second row and the third column and tell me the elements. Remove the second row, third column for the elements row wise. 1, 3, 4, minus 2. Now, what is this value becomes now?
14.
Is it clear? Minor and cofactor?
Yes, sir.
Now, let us define the determinant. So far, we have discussed this what determinant. 2 by 2 only we have discussed, as well as what? 1 by 1 only we have discussed. Now let us discuss whatever may be the order of a square matrix. How to calculate determinant? Right, determinant of a square matrix of order n. Determinant of a square matrix of order n. Determinant of a square matrix of order n is the sum of products of is the sum of products of elements of any row in bracket or column, close the bracket again. Sum of the products of elements of any row in bracket or column with the corresponding cofactors of it, with the corresponding cofactors of it. So this is the definition of a determinant of a square matrix of order n. Check once again. Sum of the products of elements of, either you can use a row or you can use a column, with the corresponding cofactors. Now let us take a 3x3 matrix again, general matrix A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. So I am taking a 3x3 matrix. Now, as per the definition, so determinant of A, we can use any row with the corresponding cofactors or any column again with the corresponding cofactors. Now let us use the first row and the corresponding cofactors. So what I can write determinant of A is using the first row. A11 corresponding cofactor, capital A11, plus A12 capital A12, plus A13 capital A13. Check whether I understood this notation or not. Remember, you have to use only one row only or one column only. So we have used the first row, that is A11 with its corresponding cofactor, A12 with its corresponding cofactor, A13 with its corresponding cofactor. Now, using the first row, in the same manner, tell me using the first column what I should write. Using the first column, A11 capital A11 plus
A21.
Correct. A21 capital A21 plus A31 capital A31. Now let us expand this also again for the expanded form of a 3x3. So determinant of A equal to A11. So we are using the first row, expanded form. So A11. Tell me what is capital A11 cofactor. So minus 1 to the power of 1 plus 1, that is 2, M11. Plus A12 minus 1 to the power of 1 plus 2, 3, M12. Plus A13 minus 1 to the power of 1 plus 3, 4, M13. Now, A11 minus 1 whole square is positive. Now write the determinant, A11 into M11. Tell me what is M11 here? 2x2 determinant, removing the first row and removing the first column. First row, A22, A23. Next,
A32, A33.
Next, observe the second term. Minus 1 whole cube is there. That means minus A12 into, again, tell me the determinant, 2x2. By removing the first row and the second column. But the first row, A21, A23. Next, second row,
A33.
A31, A33. Good. Next, plus third term, minus 1 to the power of 4, which is positive. So a13 into, again, determinant. So remove the first row and third column. a21, a22, first row.
a31,
a32. Now again expand this. So a11 into, how to calculate this determinant? a22, a33 minus a32, a23. Minus a12 into a21, a33 minus a31, a23 plus a13 into a21, a32 minus a31, a22. So this will be the expanded form. So remember here, you can use either the first row or first column or second row or second column, any row or any column with the corresponding cofactors only you have to use. That's the definition. Now, let us take a numerical example now. So A equal to minus 2, 1, 0, 3, minus 1, 4, 1, 3, 5. Now, calculate the determinant using first row. So calculate the determinant using first row. So determinant of A equal to so what I should write now using the first row. So minus 2 into corresponding cofactor. So it will be plus only. So what the corresponding cofactor will be?
Minus 5, minus 12.
Minus 5, minus 12. Next term. So here it will be what? Minus 1 you will get into 15 minus 4. Next. Plus 0 into corresponding cofactor. 9 plus 1. Now, check the value now. How much?
23.
34 here. And here it is how much? Minus
11.
What's the value?
23.
Now, here we have used the first row. Now, let us take using second column. Calculate the determinant using second column. Using the second column. Now, so 1 into what is the corresponding cofactor of this? What is the corresponding cofactor of this? Minus 1. To the power of what? I plus j. And what is this notation? This will be, this is a11, this is a12, and this will be what? a22, and this will be a32. Now, so 1 into what I'll get? Minus 1 to the power of 1 plus 2. So I'll get as minus 1 into determinant. Now, can you able to say directly determinant? By removing the first row and the second column.
15 minus 4.
Correct. 15 minus 4. Next, you have to use what? A22. A22 into what? Minus 1 to the power of I plus j, which is positive. So you'll get as what? Minus 1 into again. Remove the second row, second column, and tell me the determinant value.
Minus 10.
Minus 10, minus 0. Next, third term. A 3 2, which is the corresponding cofactor? Now, I to the power of I plus A minus 1 to the power of I plus J becomes minus 1. So I can write as directly minus 3 into remove the third row and second column. What I'll get? Minus 8
minus
0. Now simplify this and check. Will you get the same answer or not? This is how much? Minus 11. And this is plus 10 and plus 24. Now, 23. How much? 20. Now, whether you use the row wise or column wise, the determinant value, you should get the same only. If you are getting different, means you are using somewhere calculation mistake. Now let us write for a 4x4 determinant. How to calculate? Now 4x4 determinant. 3, minus 1, 2, 0, 1, 4, 3, 5, minus 1, 0, 2, 1, 1, 2, minus 3, 4. Equal to. Now, as per the definition, you write first. Let us use here also first row. Tell me using the first row, the expanded form. So determinant. So the first element is what this is. A11, A12, A13, A14. Now, as per the definition, tell me what? A11, capital A11, A12, capital A12, A13, capital A13, A14, capital A14. Check, have you understood this first? Sum of the products of elements of a row with the corresponding cofactors. Now, so A11 is what? 3. Now, capital A11 is what? Cofactor of an element A11. Now, what is the cofactor definition? Minus 1 to the power of I plus J. Tell me 1 plus 1. It is 1 only. Into determinant of. What is the order now? A11 will be a what? Determinant of order 3. How to obtain that? By removing the first row and first column. Now, when I remove the first row and first column, what is obtained? That means 4, 3, 5, 0, 2, 1, 2, minus 3, 4. This determinant you have to calculate. Next, second term, A12. What is A12? Minus 1 into minus 1 to the power of I plus J. What is minus 1 to the power of I plus J? So minus 1 to the power of 1 plus 2. That means again you will get minus 1. Into again. Minor of A12. Now, what is the minor? You have to remove the first row and the second column. So, remove the first row and second column. Tell me the elements. First row elements. By removing the first row and second column.
1, 3, 5.
Next, second row.
Minus 1, 2, 1.
Third row.
1, minus 3, 4.
Next, third term, A13. What is A13? Plus 2 into minus 1 to the power of 1 plus 3, which is positive, into. Tell me again, determinant. by removing the first row and the third column.
1, 4, 5.
First row, third column. First row, 1, 4, 5. Good. Next.
-1, 0, 1.
Next.
4, 1, 2, 4.
One more term. A14. What is A14? 0 into -1 to the power of 1 plus 4, 5. That is -1 into determinant of. Remove the first row and fourth column. What is left out? Element. 1, 4, 3. -1, 0, 2.
1, 2, -3.
Now this value you have to calculate. Okay, that you can able to calculate. Now, previously we have discussed how to calculate this 3 by 3 determinant, expanded form, either row wise or column wise, and simplify and calculate. This portion you do later. Just see that whether you understood how to calculate determinant of a square matrix of order 4, and this can be extended further. Next, one more concept. Singular and non-singular matrix. Right? Singular and non-singular matrix. Write the definition. A square matrix A square matrix A of order N is said to be singular. A square matrix A of order N is said to be singular if determinant of the matrix A is 0. Okay. If the determinant of the square matrix A is 0. Mute it. A square matrix A of order N is said to be singular if determinant of it is 0. Now, you can able to guess what should be non-singular.
Not equal to zero.
Right. That is a square matrix A of order N is said to be non-singular if determinant of A is not equal to zero. Let us take an example. A equal to 3, 4, 2, 1. Calculate the determinant. Determinant of A. What is the value? 3 minus 8. How much? -5. Not equal to 0. So A is said to be singular or non-singular?
Non-singular.
Right. Non-singular. Now let us take one more example. A equal to 3, 6, 2, 4. Now calculate this determinant. How much? 12 minus 12, 0. That means it is a singular matrix. Take the booklet, all of you. Start lecture 1, suggested problems. Now, first problem, letter one. Determine the integral value of x for which the matrix A is singular. X plus 1, minus 3, 4, minus 5, x plus 2, 2, 4, 1, x minus 6. Now, as per the statement, A is singular. Means what? Determinant of A equal to what? 0. Now, calculate the determinant now and equate it to 0 and then solve. Expand and simplify all of you. X plus 1 into x plus 2 x minus 6 minus 2. Next, minus 3 into minus of minus plus 3 minus 5 into x minus 6 minus 8 plus 4 into minus 5 minus 4 into x plus 2. Now expand this and solve. So x plus 1 into x square minus 6x plus 2x. So minus 4x minus 12 minus 2 minus 14 plus 3 into minus 5x plus 30 minus 8, that is 22, plus 4 into minus 4x minus 8 minus 5, so minus 13 equal to 0. Now, expand entirely and tell me what the equation you are getting, cubic equation or a quadratic equation?
Cubic.
Have you expanded entirely?
Yes.
Tell me the cubic equation what you are getting.
X cube minus 3x square
minus 49x.
Tell me again, x cube
minus 3x square
minus 3x square
minus 49x
minus 49. Yes. That's all?
Yes.
Now, equal to? Zero.
Yeah.
Are you getting the same all of you? X cube yes. Minus 3x square minus 49x equal to 0. Is there anything common?
Yes.
X. Take out x common. Then remaining will be a quadratic. So x square minus 3x minus 49 equal to 0. That means x equal to 0. R. Solve this quadratic equation. X equal to 3 plus or minus root of how much? Tell me the value.
205
upon how much?
Two.
Now, as per the statement, for the answer,
zero.
X equal to zero because it is asked integral value of x. So that the matrix is singular. If it is not mentioned integral value, then the answer will be what? 0 as well as this. Now, second problem. Find the minors and the cofactors of the elements of the matrix. So for each element, you need to calculate minor as well as cofactor. So capital A equal to 1, 3, minus 2, 4, minus 5, 6, 3, 5, 2. So you have to write minor as well as cofactors. So that means M11, M12. So you need to calculate all this. M11, M12, M13. Next, M21, M22, M23. Next, M31, M32, M33. After that, cofactors A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. Now calculate and tell me all this. What is M11?
Minus 40.
Correct. Next, M12. Remove the first
minus
row
10.
Minus
and
10.
The second column. Minus?
10.
How much?
10.
So we are removing the first row and second column. That is 8 minus 18. Next, M13.
35.
35, correct. Next, M21, second
16.
Row, first column.
16.
16. Next, M22.
8.
8.
Correct. M23.
Minus 4.
Second row, third column.
Minus 4.
Correct. M31, remove the third row,
eight.
First column.
8.
8.
8. Next, M32, remove 14. The third row, second column.
14.
14, correct.
14.
Next, M33, remove the third
minus
row, 17. Third column. How much?
Minus
17.
Minus 17. Now, using the minus, you can write easily the cofactors. Now, tell me what is A11?
Minus 40.
Minus 40. A12.
10.
10.
10. A13.
35.
35. A21.
Minus 16.
A22.
8.
A23.
Minus 4.
Check once again. A23.
Plus 4. Sorry.
Plus 4. Next. A31.
8.
8. A32.
Minus 14.
Minus 14. A33.
Minus 17.
Minus 17. Okay. Try the third problem. Check yes. First whether you understood the question or not. A equal to 2, 4 minus 5 minus 1. Show that determinant of 3A equal to 9 times determinant of A. First, you calculate the inside, 3a. How to calculate 3a? You have to multiply 3 with all the elements. Now, that is 6, 12, minus 15, minus 3. Now calculate determinant of 3a. That is determinant of 6, 12, minus 15, minus 3. Now, tell me what you are going to get.
162.
Minus 18. Minus of minus plus. How much?
118.
No. 15 into 12. Minus of minus plus. 150 plus 30. 180. Now, how much is this value?
162.
162. Correct. Now, calculate determinant of A separately. Determinant of A. Determinant of 2, 4, minus 5, minus 1. What is this value? Minus 2 plus 20. How much it is? 18. Now, what the right hand side you are having is 9 into determinant of A. That is 9 into 18.
160.
What is the value? 160. Now here we have done numerically that determinant of 3 times of a matrix is equal to what? 9 into determinant of A. Is there any observation here? What is the observation here?
Raised to the power 2.
That is when I take a constant times any matrix inside the determinant and taking outside, then I should raise how much power?
Order of the given matrix.
Yes. That is when I take outside 3, I should write as 3 square into determinant of A. That anyway we are going to discuss in the properties. Next problem. 4. A equal to 1, 5, 7, 6, 7, 2, 1, 2, 3. Now show that determinant of 2A equal to 8 into determinant of A. Now calculate separately 2A again. After that, determinant. And then determinant of A. And then multiply with 8. And check whether they are equal or not. What is determinant of A will be here? 1 into 21 minus 4. Now, how to remember is here, just you take the element corresponding cross product. After that, whenever you use the first row, first element with a plus, you take next element with a minus, next element will be plus. That instead of writing minus 1 to the power of I plus j, you take plus, minus, plus. So 1 into 21 minus 4 minus 5 into 18 minus 2 plus 7 into 12 minus 7. How much value? This is 21 minus 4. 17. Here it is. 16 Pfizer. How much?
80.
Next. Plus. How much this is? 5. 35. Simplify and tell me how much you are getting.
224.
Check minus once again. 80. Take the value once again. This is how much? 40, 52. 52 minus 80. How much?
Minus 28.
Minus 28. Now, let us calculate 2A and then determinant. So 2A. That is multiply all the elements with the 2. So 2, 10, 14. Next, 12, 14, 4, 2, 4, 6. Now, calculate determinant of 2A and tell me what you will get. After that, you calculate 8 into determinant of A and tell me what you are going to get.
Minus 224.
Minus 224.